Hi, my name is Kristin Kaufman, and I am here to address the infamous question that I am asked all the time. How in the world can I start a business when I am so busy already? I don't give a clue or have a clue about social media and how to take advantage of it. And most importantly, I really don't have a network. I mean, the network I have is the one that's around my current role, my current job, and I don't really even think it's applicable to a new job or a new company that I would start. Well, I'm here to tell you, I relate to all three of those questions. My name is Kristin Kaufman, and I'm in the business of helping people create the life they want without giving up the creature comforts that they want. As a recovering corporate executive and newly budded entrepreneur about 15 years ago, I actually faced all three of these challenges of starting a business in today's arena. After all, we are in the 21st century, so these realities are not unique to me. Everybody is busy. I think people are running faster than they've ever run. And for people who think that if they shut their eyes and close their ears, that technology and the advent of social media and technology in every pervasive crevice of our life is going to go away, that's just folly. It's not going to go away. It's here forever. It's going to be here probably in even a more pervasive position than it is today. And then for those people who think, or perhaps they have been in a corporate job for many years and that's really the only network they have, or perhaps they have not even been working. Maybe they're at home and they have no network outside of perhaps the people they go to church with, or maybe a book club that they're in. I have news for you. You have a bigger network than you think. So I want to take each one of these three objections, so to speak, and just knock them down. I'm going to look the tiger in the eye and I'm just going to knock them down. The first is, my mama and daddy used to always say, busy people get things done. And you know what? That is absolutely true. I think that when I have time on my hands, I become somewhat lackadaisical, to be perfectly honest. The busier I am, the more active I am, and the more things I can get done. So frankly, when I'm looking for business partners, and I'm looking for people with whom I want to work, I want someone who's busy. I want somebody who has a lot of balls in the air, because that tells me they know how to juggle. No pun intended. I want people that are busy. And the busier we are forces us and becomes a catalyst for us to become very organized, very time management sophisticated. We know how to prioritize our time. We know how to manage our time more effectively, making a lot happen in a very short period of time. And in some cases, kill two birds with one stone. So if you're thinking to yourself, I am so busy, I don't have time to add one more thing to my plate, and yet you're not really fulfilled in what you're doing, or perhaps the life is not the one that you want, my question to you is, how can you afford not to take the time to invest in something that potentially could free you up to create the life that you want? And you know what? If you're busy, great. That just tells me that we will have to work to prioritize where and how you spend your time. So to me, that is not really a great excuse, if you will, to not move forward in a direction that will ultimately fulfill you and help you create the life you want. Being busy to me is, frankly, it's necessary. If you're not busy, then you're probably not optimizing the time that you have in front of you. So that's my answer to the first one. I want busy people, because busy people get things done. The second, I'm not a social media maven. I'm not even sure I know how to log on to Facebook or Twitter or Snapchat or LinkedIn or Instagram, you name it, I get it. But you know what? What I'd also say to that is, lifelong learners, people who are constantly wanting to improve themselves and learn, are the ones that will ultimately create and get the most out of life. When we become stagnant and we become comfortable in doing things the way we've always done them, then we are probably not exercising our muscles, meaning our learning muscles. And I will tell you, when I first got into this, into my entrepreneurship 15 years ago, I didn't know squat from squat. I didn't know how to blog. I did not, frankly, even, I didn't know anything. And I'm still learning. I'm still not sure I know half of what I need to know. I've actually hired a coach to help me learn how to create videos, to upload videos to YouTube, to create a way to manage my business online. Because I'm here to tell you, whether I like it or not, the days of, you know, glad handing and pressing the flesh as the sole way, I still think it's a very important way, but it is not the sole way that we will build out a global business. It's just not scalable. And it's frankly, it's not cost justifiable in many ways to zip on over to Sydney, Australia, or to zip on up to Saskatoon, Canada on a monthly basis to help build out a business. When really you have to, we can learn how to leverage Zoom. We can learn how to leverage Facebook Live, and we learn how to use Skype, and we learn all of these different technologies to integrate as part of our business. I absolutely think it is the only way that we will ultimately become relevant in the 21st century of building a business. So if you're not a social media maven, my thought would be, what's holding you back from becoming one? I mean, I'm in the business of learning all the time, and I will surround myself with people who are the best at what they do to help me learn the skills that I don't have today. Because you know what? If they can do it, I can do it. So that would be my second answer to the second objection of, I don't know what I don't know about social media. Who says you can't learn it? And we have so many skills and ways to do that in today's arena that it should not hold you back. In fact, if anything, it could be very exciting as a new way to embrace this new technology to build out your business. And the third thing, and boy, I've heard this a lot, I don't have a network. I don't have a network. And the network I did have was in my old industry. And I'm not even sure that industry and those people in that industry are relevant in my new business. Well, I have two things to say to that. One of my most beloved mentors in one of my businesses is a woman who left her corporate career late in her career. And it was a male-dominated career, and it was one that really was not, quote-unquote, perceived relevant in her new business. And she blew through that network pretty fast, and she wasn't sure what she was going to do, and here's what she did. She got out and among them. She got out in the world, and she started meeting with people on the street, so to speak, whether it be at Walgreens, at the library, at church, at lunch, at the bar, at the dry cleaners. And she began to just share her new trajectory in her life. And people who were interested clamored to learn more. People who weren't interested, okay, no harm, no foul, they went on. So there is a network at our disposal in the world today, both physically, like in pressing the flesh, and of course through social media. So to say to yourself, I don't have a network, my challenge to you is, yes, you do. And it's a matter of getting out and among them to build those new relationships, both in person, but also on the internet. And then the second thing that I would say, and this is just a sociological truism, everybody in the world has a sphere of influence of about 250 people. Okay. And those are people that could be your school teachers. They could be people from church. They could be your physicians. They could be the people that work on your car, your dry cleaners, as I've mentioned before. And those 250 people also have 250 people. And those 250 people also have 250 people. And so before you know it, you have this compounding network of people that are all within, you know, a certain percentage of separation from you, of those 250 people of your sphere of influence. So, you know, I get it. Believe me, I get it. Because when I was launching out my business, I would say I burned through what we call our warm market pretty fast. You know, both in all of my businesses, I burned through that warm market pretty fast. Some people weren't interested. Some people were interested, but they really didn't have a need for what I was offering. And so I had to get beyond myself to build out a new network and to not get in my own way and to ask for introductions, to ask for referrals, and to extend my reach via social media. So it can be done. So for those people who think, man, I'd love to start a business in this, in today's world, because I know that where I am now, this 8-to-5 job isn't going to take me where I want it to go, but I'm just really busy. I don't really know social media, and I know how that's how most things are done. And frankly, I don't even have a network. I have been married to this job for so long. That's my only network. I would ask you to dig deeper than that and to look yourself in the mirror and say, if I want it badly enough, I'll make the time. If I want it badly enough, I can learn social media, because I didn't know my current job when I first started this current job, and I learned it. And then third, gosh, I would love to get to know new people and to share potentially what I have with other people so that they can actually create the life they want as well. So that is my answer to those three objections. My name is Kristin Kaufman. I'm in the business of helping people create the life they want without giving up the creature comforts that they want. And if you have any interest in learning more about how I do this, you can just Google me at partnerwithkristin.com, or you can comment below and I'll be in touch with you, and we can discuss possibly new ventures for you to consider and possibly just a new way to think about the current venture that you're on. I would love nothing more. Make it a great day.